What is going on, everybody? DJ Minds here, and today we're talking about the MNTD drop, and then we're going to get into my Helium setup and what's going on with me. So I've been waiting like a week for this drop, maybe a little bit more, actually. I was there for the countdown. I woke up on time. I was so hyped, man. I think so many people were all over YouTube because Voscoin and a lot of people have been talking about it and stuff. Last time I got the black one. So after the last drop, I found out that this is actually 8 gigs. And I was like, you know what, man? I'd rather have the gold one because it's just like with GPUs. Like you'll start off and maybe something only takes 3 or 4 gigs and then eventually they upgrade to 6 and 8. And I was like, I don't even want to deal with all that, man. Like I'm actually really enjoying Helium mining. The profits we'll get into in a bit. They haven't been good for me. And again, we'll get into that. So last launch was smooth as butter, man. I was there on time. I pretty much clicked it what I wanted. I got 2. I could have bought up to 5, but I didn't really see a need for me having 5. Yeah, so I got 2 of the black ones and it was instant checkout. Bam, done, smooth. There wasn't a lot of traffic. There wasn't a lot of lag. This time was terrible. I think I waited almost an hour just to get in because it kept saying like loading, 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 and it just would keep saying that over and over, and everybody was complaining in here, which I totally understand. But yeah, you can see on the Twitter, man, there were so many people complaining, and thank goodness a lot of people ended up getting it this time. I'm sure the 2 helped a lot more, but it sold out as of, let's see, 2 hours ago. It could be more than that, but it took about an hour for people to really even buy anything, and I was like really heated because I just kept refreshing and refreshing and nothing was happening and nothing was being sold. It was really annoying, and then I guess the bots came over. That's what I'm assuming. That was really the feeling, because like I said, last time was very quick, very smooth, but this time the bots took over big time. Again, looking at their Twitter page, they posted these pictures, what you need to know about the third drop. I'm assuming that this is the third drop. They dropped 2,900 more miners than last time, adjusted the order limit from 5 to 2, and fixed the Amex credit card checkout. Took them 1 hour and 13 minutes to fully sell out. So for this drop, they ended up selling 10,865. That is not that many. A little more than I thought it'd be though, with an average of 2 miners per order. I mean, it should be 2 orders, 2 per person, right? That's what they said it would be. So if we look at the gold statistic to the black, as you can see, there's a little bit more gold, 5,865 to 5,000 black miners. That's kind of weird actually, because the black miners are supposed to not be the limited ones. The gold spot are supposed to be limited, but there's really nothing limited about it considering there's more of them than the regular. And yeah, they charge you a lot more for 4 gigs, and I can't imagine the 4 gigs costing the difference. I mean, the whole thing is this big. I'll show you in a little bit. It's so tiny. So yeah, they sold more limited stock than they did regular. Unsurprisingly, I'm sure there was a lot of bots. Let's just look at this real quick. We received over 1 million requests, 21 million website visits, 21,460,000 automated attempts blocked. Like I've had it where I tried to buy sneakers when I was younger and I would open up like 7 tabs and that would get you blocked. So it could be bots or it could just be people opening too many tabs. Don't be greedy. Don't open too many tabs because a lot of times, you know, that will come up as you being a botter. Our automated bot protection was put to heavy use this drop. 28 attempted orders. 28 people tried to cheat the system pretty much is how I'm seeing that. 10,000 supply, 232,000 people visit. And here they just say that they're sorry how it worked out. I did feel really bad for them because you can't blame them. From what I was watching, when I was watching it live, it really wasn't on them. It was on Shopify, and I'm trying to look for that right now. So here's the tweet that everybody was talking about. Rate limiter kicked in preventing inventory from being sold at Shopify. Help a friend. Yeah, so that's the difference, right, between one release. The last one, smooth as butter, pretty much you could buy it if you wanted to and you were there the first 5, 10, 15 minutes, and then, you know, a lot of YouTubers talk about it, including myself, I guess, right now, and then that's just what happens, man. The botters catch on, and you know, a lot of people see money in it because these things sell really well. Bottom line, you buy them for 400, or the gold one for like 480 plus shipping, so 500 bucks or like 430 bucks. Yeah, and then you can double your money on eBay. So I mean, I'm not buying them to resell them, but it is nice knowing that you, if it doesn't work in your area or it's not good for you, you know, or you're not really trying to buy an antenna and get a whole setup, that you always could get your money back pretty easily, if not a lot more. So that's a really nice feeling. You know, you don't want to buy something and then it become less valuable. And pretty much if you buy it, you already know you'll get at least your money back fairly easy. Here's a photo of what mine's going on. I don't want to show you on the actual website itself, right? I don't need you knowing exactly where I live. But yeah, we've had big problems. We haven't really been getting any payouts. And I don't think that's our fault. I think that's because I was on their Discord and they were doing something. I don't know. There's a lot of issues or bugs, or there's some kind of server issues. I'm not really sure. So the payouts have pretty much been non-existent the last 24 to 48 hours. It's been a rough time to be a Helium miner. So the price of HNT is down about 5%. So that's really unfortunate, but so is ETH and Bitcoin, and everything else has been really bad. like the last 24 hours because there's like these new regulations, and I'm not going to get into that on this video, but it's still not bad overall. I mean, if you look at the last 3 months of Helium, you know, you've been making money. I haven't, just because I don't have an antenna just yet, and I'll show you that in a minute. But yeah, the price isn't crazy or anything. There's a dip right now. You know, we'll see what happens. Maybe it'll consolidate, maybe it'll go up a little bit more, but nothing to panic about at this current moment in the 45 range. I mean, if you've been doing this the last year, you're booming. You're making crazy money if you've been doing this the last year. $11 back in June. I mean, even what is this, October, September, $20, you know, we're up 45. It was 50 just the other day. So I mean, you're making bank if you've been doing H&T and you don't have a stock antenna like I do. So as far as antenna, this one was not too expensive. It was like $67. We ended up getting this thanks to Austin. I don't remember the last part of his name, but he's in the Discord and he's very helpful. I think that was Red Fox Discord. Really nice guy named Austin. 6 dBi. This is good for me, I think, because I'm really worried if I could put this outside. I don't think I can. I might just put it up. It doesn't look like it's very big. I've spoken to a few people that have this and they said it's not bad at all. It's only like 2-3 feet tall. So I don't know. I'll try it in like the corner of my room. I know you're not supposed to put it inside, but I don't know, man. Where I live, they're going to flip out if they start seeing a huge antenna. So I'm going to try it in the corner of my room and then maybe the center of my room. And if that doesn't work out at all, I guess I'll have to put it outside. But I can't imagine this 6 dBi being any worse than the stock antenna that I have from the MNDT. That's really not that big, man. And obviously it doesn't come with this bottom pole, but yeah, I'm thinking about figuring out a way to get this just stand up in my room. We also ended up getting this, which should help with the grounding. This was like $23. I could put a link for all this in the description below. If you want, let me know. I'll throw it in there. Yeah, that should help when we do put it outside if it hits by lightning. And we did end up getting the 30-foot antenna cable, and I'm sure I won't need most of this, but that's fine. You know, I'll use it. I'll figure it out. But that was only $52 for like the whole 30-foot. So I think that's good. I think that's good to go, and that's not a bad setup. So if we add this up, $66.97 plus $22.97 plus $52.97. And that comes to a grand total of $142.91. And I believe shipping was like $20 or $15. I got like a little bit of expedited. It wasn't much. So we'll call that $160 total. So for the black one that I have, that's, you know, $600 total invested. That's really not that bad, to be honest. So yeah, $600. I mean, it's basically the price of a GPU and it sits in the corner of your room. And then that's pretty much it. You forget about it. And I can't say if this is good or not. I'm not telling you to go out, rush out and buy a 6 dBi antenna. I don't know. I mean, I think it's going to be good. I can't imagine it being worse than what I have, because right now I'm making anywhere from like 10 to 30 cents a day. I had one day where I made like a dollar, but it's been really rough with the stock antenna, right? No hate to the actual Helium miner. I mean, I knew what I was getting into. I knew that I would need an antenna, or it's really not worth your time unless you have a lot of people really close by, which I don't. So yeah, I was successful and I got a gold today. It took about an hour, maybe 50 minutes, give or take, and we got one. So I will be upgrading from the black one to the gold one. And then I guess I'll just sell off my black one or help out some of the other YouTubers or some of my friends, you know, with the other one. I don't know. I don't really have anybody near me that I want to bother and be like, dude, can I put this in your house, right? It's not a big deal, but at the same time, you know, I would need a real antenna for that, I'm pretty sure. And I'm not going to put a real antenna on somebody's house. So definitely let me know if you guys were successful, how the launch was for you. I hope it was better for you than it was for a lot of people. Like I said, it was rough for me, man. I was there the second it went live and it took almost an hour and it was very frustrating clicking and clicking, but we were successful. If you do want to see more Helium content on the channel, please consider subscribing, giving this video a thumbs up, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. DJ Mines signing out.